Thank you, Anand. All right, thank you. I'm here representing INCATE, which stands for the Incubator for Antibiotic Therapies Europe. And I felt very humbled and over the last 1.5 days, so I felt I had to put a slide about my research. And you'll notice it's an empty set. There is none. But what I do have is weak ties. And that's what INCATE works on, and that's what I was really excited to hear from Jonas, was this concept of weak ties. That's what we try and do at INCATE, and what I try and do personally, and what I can give to this auditorium today and the forum going forward. So INCATE, which I'll talk about, there's also some weak ties I can tell you about so you can follow up later when I get my glass of chai tea. There's INCATE, there's the University of Basel. There's also Swiss Leading House Africa is something that I'm part of, which is a program in Switzerland where we try and connect to low and middle income countries in Africa. And I think that's a really interesting connection that we can have also with India. I'm also Australian and I'm quite well connected with the AMR network there, and a bit Swedish, and you know, you can always get the Swedes to come and talk. This is the pipeline. I'm going to talk a little bit about the pipeline and how we support early stage companies, and then we'll talk to some of the aspects later with, from the rest of the great panel. This is the pipeline. It was awesome for a while, number of years in the middle, everyone could make lots of money. Then we stopped doing things. And we talk often about the desert of development in antibiotics. And do we mean an empty desert where there's nothing there? We actually don't. We mean there are some sprouts, and I'm going to talk a little bit around what we do with that. So there are some sprouts and what we perhaps should do in terms of development. So there are some sprouts in the desert, and should we just add some water? Do we just give them a bit of money and everything will be all right? You know, we can just give, you know, some academics some money and the world will be solved? No. If we give academics some money and let them do what they would like, we'll end up with this. We'll end up with a bunch of weeds. Many... And that would be kind of good, but it wouldn't actually solve the problem. What we actually need to do is tend to the plants and work on it. We need to actually provide some direction and control, as well as some water, and then things will get better. And maybe we'll end up with a whole series of flowers that will be blooming in the desert. And that won't necessarily solve the problem, but we'll be on the way. And that's what INCATE's trying to do. We're trying to create and support and build as many flowers as possible. Looking forward, what needs to happen after INCATE's built some flowers, we'll have to kill some of them. We'll have to get rid of some of these projects and we'll have to focus. And we'll need to find some, you know, that's a gardener there. But if we only have one gardener, we'll end up with a monoculture like this. If there's only one funder saying one thing, we'll have one solution for AMR, and we know that that won't work. So we also need to have many gardeners. So we need to have many people coming after INCATE and seeing what they can do to the field. And in the future, with many gardeners, we'll have a healthy forest. That's what has to happen, and I'm not sure how we'll get there, but I think as we go forward, we need to be thinking about many flowers and many gardeners working together to build us a forest in AMR. So this is a little bit... building on how INCATE actually works. So if you think about, you know, this could be a pipeline in antibiotics, we could maybe do diagnostics, also digital tools. But if you think about it, you've got this research all the way through to the market. And there is some money, and you know, you can do a bit of research and you can keep going there for a while. But there are some people over there, Carbex, and Martin will give you some money as well, he'll invest in you. But if you don't have a team and data and a good story, nothing's going to happen. You're not going to get money from Carbex or GuardP or anyone around there. And that's what we try and do at INCATE. We try and help to build the story and help to build the team. And how we, and at INCATE, oh, sorry, I got a bit too excited. When I say INCATE, INCATE is not me and it's not a small team. It's actually a group, it's a partnership firstly, and then we work as a partnership with other people outside of that. So we have academic members because we understood from the beginning we could, you know, just get our academic people together and we could build some weeds and that would be, you know, not that exciting. But if we wanted to go find some gardeners from the industry side, if there wasn't enough to do, they wouldn't be bothered. They wouldn't come and work with us. So from the beginning, we've said we need to have academic members that can bring a lot of interesting things, and that means we can be interesting to industry partners, and they'll come along and they'll help us. And then not only that, we also need to work with other people who can come and work together and build that pipeline. So that's what we do at INCATE. We try and bring everyone together around those early stage projects. Who we are is the management team of INCATE, and we're from those different academic institutions. We've just added BioAster to join. This is a German and Swiss slide, but we have a French member who's just joined. And we have a mix of skills, some people who have direct experience from drug development, other people who are well-connected into academia. We have a phage expert now, so we're getting excited about how we can work there. But what we try and do as a team is actually do this. So we have our universities and research institutions, and they're on one side, and we have industry or industry-ready projects on the other. And we try and build a bridge across that. So we provide advice, which is saying, hey, that's not a great translational plan, but here's a better one. This is how you could work. This is how you could do that. If you're thinking about, that's maybe the wrong market for that molecule, but here's some other way of thinking about it. We also think about a community, which is like, here's someone who could help you. Here's someone who could give you money. Here's someone that you could think about that could join your team. And then we give them a small amount of funding. We actually do fund people in a non-dilutive way, but we only give $10,000 in the first round and then $250,000 in the second round. So it's a very small amount of money, but that money is often catalytic. So back to our flowers. Briefly, I'll tell you a little bit about what's happening at INCATE and where we are. The first thing is, this is the number of contacts we've had. People who've reached out to INCATE and said, hey, I need some help, I've got a great idea, what can you do? And we're actually growing that. I wouldn't want to get the AI people out there to work out how much of a growth line that really is. But since we invested in resources, we're really seeing an uptick in the number of people who are talking to us and want support. Like, there's definitely a lot of people out there who want support. The people who've spoken to us already, where we began in Europe, and that's still our focus, and we began in Germany and Switzerland, that's quite a significant thing. The UK has also a strong AMR community, so we've had lots of things from there. We have about a quarter of our contacts is from the rest of the world. India, we've had 9 contacts with different organizations that have wanted to talk about things. We've had 3 proposals from India, and we've given an award to one Indian-Dutch company. Switzerland, a little bit the same, but a little bit higher scale. We've got given 2 awards to Swiss companies and more. In terms of what we see, lots of small molecules, lots of direct acting stuff. You'll see that in a bit more detail. But we also have seen biologics, phages, diagnostics. We've seen, we don't know how to really help them yet. So it was really interesting to hear today. Antivirulence is another interesting question. That's what we are. Here are the companies in some detail. We have a couple of Sebastian's BAM-A developers here. So that's in the small molecules. We also have a number of phages, a number of antivirulence things. How healthy are our flowers? Like many people in this field, they're relatively small and about to run out of money. So they're all trying to raise sort of $500,000 to $2 million in the next little while to get their relatively early stage projects going. So there needs to be more money coming. The good news is there are some more gardeners coming to join in. There's a project coming from the UK called PACE, Pathways to Antimicrobial Clinical Efficiency. They're bringing $30 million over the next couple of years, including a call that's out now for 12 projects up to a total of $10 million. Sprint is also coming this way. We're not quite sure what it will look like yet, but there is interest from the German government to do a large project that will support globally developers in high-risk projects in the field. We try and think about creative funding. We've got a call in the next couple of weeks where we'll be having a webinar talking about how can we bring more types of funding to your project. Missed out on the tea, but I'm almost finished. Another person for any people thinking of developing something in the room, Kineticos has just joined INCATE. They're a VC that's just joined the field, which is great. So there are people actually coming and being wanting to join the pipeline. Don't worry about that one. Last call, which is come see us in Basel. One thing we have with INCATE, we're going to have a phage workshop the day before the AMR conference, and then we'll have the AMR conference. So the AMR conference is in Basel from March 6th and 7th. It's, I'd say, the premier European conference, and I'd really recommend, if you're interested and have the capacity, it would be great to sort of come and visit. The INCATE will be doing a phage conference. Our friends at the NCCR will have an apéro in the evening, and then we've got 2 days of conference. So it's a really great opportunity to build on some of those ties. So I hope to see you in Basel in March, and finish there. Not quite, but anyway.
Time for two questions. Yes, please.
So when you fund in India, do you need Indian, do you have a partnership with somebody, or do you fund?
No, we fund anyone anywhere. Yeah.
May I make a quick suggestion? The type of work you guys are doing is so synchronous to what Tasleem and team are doing here at CIE. It'd be a natural partnership because without the LMIC connotation, it'd be very hard to do work.
Absolutely.
In space. Maybe it's already happening.
It's a natural fit with IA. Yeah, yes. We've had a number of conversations. I almost put Taslim's CCAMP or IHII on the slide, but I think by tomorrow we'll be able to do that.
Perfect. Great. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Our next speaker is Dr. Martin Heidecker.